2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
And welcome to the studio, Professor John Fischetti. Always lovely to have you in.
Good morning, Sarah. How are you today?
Really well. And having a bit of a chuckle to myself this morning, reading a study that says Australian parents and grandparents are travelling up to 1,500 kilometres per year just to get the babies to sleep. And you've walked in and I said, John, what's your trick? And you've looked at me and you've gone, I've done that for years.
Yeah, we did it for years. I think we had wore out a set of tires when my son was young because he was not a napper, but he needed it. You know, that age where they don't want it, but they still can use it.
Yes.
My daughter was different. When she fell asleep, she was good. Now we have a new grandbaby, and the secret to napping, get the wheels rolling.
Yeah, and you said you used to cruise through Macca's drive-through when you get the...
When the teeny beanie baby craze was on, they used to give them away as their little gift for your purchase. So we got a lot of lemonade back in the day. Way too much lemonade.
I've done the same when the kids have fallen asleep in the car and you want to keep them asleep because trying to re-wake them and then put them back to sleep, not going to happen. But I've brought a lot of coffees over the years just to keep me going, to keep the driving happening.
Yep.
You do what you've got to do.
Exactly. Whatever it takes.
It really is. Now, look, we're talking about our university study and whether that leads to jobs because there has been a lot of rumours over the last few years that, in fact, a lot of people are wasting all this time. They're going to uni, doing degrees, and then not getting into the field that they wanted to pursue and really not getting ahead because of the degree.
The good news is this most recent report shows that not only do university graduates end up a couple of years later, like 90% employed, they're making considerable extra money, which contributes to the opportunities to kind of lead a middle-class life. Because for a lot of folks do, if they don't have the proper education, they may be working, but they're settling. Maybe it's a couple casual jobs. They don't have the super benefits. They're not getting the extra opportunity to have that holiday or that car. Everybody living on the edge. So university education not only prepares you for that future you wanted, but also gives you the benefits that come along with it. That's really good news for those that were thinking we had too many people running around unemployed because they had their uni degrees, their bachelor's degrees and whatever.
And it's good to know that the salary is going to be, on average, a higher rate as well.
Yes. And now sometimes there's not a perfect match the day one out of uni. There's a number of folks that get a casual job because they can't really relocate or they may not get the perfect job. Most everybody starts like in the mailroom and works their way up kind of thing.
Oh, definitely.
It takes 3 or 4 years. But if you look at the data 3 or 4 years out, most everybody is doing something related to the skill set that they prepared for. That's changing, however, Sarah. And one of the risky parts of this data is because the workforce is changing so much, those that are doing jobs that can be replaced by machines, including the one you're doing today, which has partially been by all of the stuff you have preloaded, is probably the most vulnerable. So it's not just the degree in the specialization, it's the flexibility, versatility, critical thinking, problem solving, collaboration skills that get you prepared for the next thing.
That's
right. If you're not a people person, there's probably nothing much to do because most of what's going to be left in the next 10 years are the jobs machines can't do, which are the human kind of things.
It is that human touch, localism,
caring,
being relevant.
Caring, taking care and support of one another, anything in the healthcare area, working with young people or old people, those things which are about inventing and designing and creating just at the next level. So even if you do have a job out of uni and the skill set isn't future focused, you're probably obsolete. So it doesn't mean it's secure for the future just because you have a pretty good job. It means you're going to have to continue to reinvent yourself and use those future focused skills to sort of future proof the opportunity to maintain that life that we all want to lead.
So given all that, do you think the trend will continue to be getting degrees will lead to employment? Because the degrees will obviously keep evolving as well to be relevant for the marketplace.
So two kind of areas. One is the professional degrees and those things which we know will be out there in medicine and in law and in business, education, nursing, etc. All will have jobs for the future. Those other ones are going to be kind of mixed and interdisciplinary, where you might have a creative component mixed in with a STEM skill. You might be a very, very, very good musician, but you'll build it in with business. Mm. So I think we're going to see combinations of things that allow people to say, well, I like playing in my band. It doesn't really pay the rent, but I'm going to run my own business on the side that's about helping young people develop music and have a web presence. So you'll start to see versatility, flexibility, a adaptability being those things which are crucial.
It certainly is an interesting time. And I think I was reading that in another decade, there's a huge percentage of jobs that aren't even created yet, that we can't even fathom what will be and what we'll be doing.
And
so it's crazy.
Yeah, there's been so, in the last 10 or 15 years, cybersecurity, one of the largest growth areas in the world, and you know how vital that is. 20 years ago, it was only in its infancy, or it was tucked into the defense force, not in the regular public. Anything with Wi-Fi, there's all these issues around that. So continue to evolve the technology, then there'll be jobs that spin off of that that help us all live good lives as well. So I think the good news is anybody with a current degree is probably found their way forward to do something pretty well with that. If they haven't, they probably got to reinvent themselves, because it's going to be something around the people skills and the flexibility skills that are going to be the things that get them the next job. For those people coming out soon, they need to have that maybe dual or tri level of adaptability so that they can be versatile and move around wherever the jobs end up becoming.
Some great advice and a very interesting topic. Professor John Fischetti, thank you so much for coming in today.